It's easy to add a picture-in-picture effect to a media composer sequence. Let's continue by watching this short sequence from previous exercises.
They run into burning buildings to rescue people, while their opponents sweep the bad guys off the streets. Both are dedicated to serving the public, but now the only thing that matters is their training.
I'm going to navigate to the upper right corner of the composer window and choose an earlier version of this sequence so we can reconstruct it. Start by marking an area in your sequence for where you want the picture-in-picture to go. Patch the V1 source track to the V2 sequence track. Also, make sure this monitor icon is located on the V2 track. Load the clip of the fireman driving into the source window. Then, press the red overwrite button or the blue replace button to edit the clip into the marked area of the sequence. And remember, you can also press the B key on your keyboard. Navigate to the top of the project window and click on the Effects Palette tab. Then click on the Blend category. Find the picture-in-picture effect and drag it to the sequence onto the clip segment that's on V2. This will automatically scale the clip segment to 50% and it will place it in the middle of the screen. Next, make sure the position indicator is parked over the clip segment and navigate to the upper left corner of the timeline window and press the Effect Mode button. The Effect Editor window will appear. You can now make adjustments to the picture-in-picture by adjusting these sliders, or by dragging the wireframe of the clip within the Composer window. Notice this creates a pink keyframe at the bottom of the record side of the Composer window. For this lesson, it's important that the position indicator remains parked over this keyframe. Otherwise, you may end up with additional keyframes, and your picture-in-picture effect will automatically move from one keyframe to another. Now, don't worry, I'll talk more about keyframing in a different exercise. Okay, so now, to add another picture-in-picture effect, repeat the same steps again. If you need another video track, right-click in the gray area of the timeline window and choose New Video Track. Patch the V1 source track to V3 and move the video monitoring icon to the V3 track. Make sure all the other sequence tracks are turned off. Now mark another area using in and out points on the V3 track above your last clip segment on V2. Load a clip of the policeman driving into the source window. Then press the overwrite or replace arrow to edit the clip to the sequence. Navigate back to the project window and place the picture-in-picture effect onto the clip segment that's on V3. Press the Effect Mode button again to open the Effect Editor window. Then adjust the picture-in-picture off to the other side. Now, you'll notice that the policeman is driving the wrong way. To fix the problem, you can nest a filter into the picture-in-picture effect. To do this, double-click on the clip segment that's on V3. This will open something called a nest. Navigate back to the project window, and within the effects, look for the image category. Find the flop effect. Drag the flop effect onto the V1.2 track that's nested within the V3 track. Then double-click on the segment that's on V3 to collapse it. Okay, fantastic. Now you have the basics of creating a picture-in-picture with a nested effect.
The bad guys off the streets. Both are dedicated to serving the public.
And don't forget, Genius TV also offers classroom and flat rate on-site Avid Media Composer training.